Good evening from New Jersey. It is Joe's Garage. It is open. It's the start of a holiday weekend, but it's the start of a vacation for me as well. It's been a busy week and more to come. So first, we saw a play last night in New York City. This is Prima Facie. It closes on Sunday, but we were able to get in for the play. It's a very serious type of play. And vacation starts. Where am I going? I'm going to Texas. Why am I going to Texas? Because it's the World Championships of Model Rocketry, and I am volunteering. I'm leaving for Texas. There's a mail call. Here's the first one. Just arrived. This is the new Eric Clapton box set. It shows in the Royal Albert Hall, and now it's the complete shows, which of course, you know, me getting bootlegs, I like. That's number one. Number two, picked up a mug at Tiki Weekend last weekend from a fellow collector who has 4,000 mugs. So just to put it in perspective, this was really cool. I like it. Let's imprison it. So I am going to Texas in the heat. Oh boy. I'm also going to visit SpaceX too, down in Boca Chica. So this is Papi Calle from Lone Rider. Outlaws, Texas. And this is a cool mug. Let's christen it. That's a good beer. Delicious. See you in Texas. I will not come back with a cowboy hat. Maybe I'll meet Elon Musk. Never know. Make it a great day and a good holiday weekend. Happy 4th of July. From Joe's Garage, today in New Jersey, next week, Texas. Yeehaw. Good morning from San Antonio, Texas. Hey, it's the Alamo. How about that? Remember the Alamo? Yeah, I'm down in Texas for a week and gonna visit a friend today. Stay tuned. It's 11 a.m. It's 90 degrees. That's hot. But that's why I'm here. Making a great day from the Alamo.
For now, I wanted to start off with noting that it's almost the 4th of July and celebrate our national independence from Great Britain. And the United States was fortunate that we had powerful foreign allies to help us to take on Great Britain. One of those famously was the French, and another was Spain. Spain was a co-belligerent after 1779. And so if you guys have ever been to Galveston, Texas, that's Galvez, apparently, Galveston. And that's named after Bernardo de Galvez, who was the Spanish commander on the third coast. He and Spanish forces under his command stormed Mobile and what is today Alabama and Pensacola, Florida. So the weapon that I'm going to show for you today to start with, held by this Alamo defender, is a Spanish escopeta. The Spanish escopeta, as you can see, is a single-shot, muzzle-loaded, smooth-bore weapon. And that was a very commonly encountered firearm on the Spanish frontier. The weapon in my hand that I'm showing you, obviously is a lot shorter than an escopeta. And this is a blunderbuss. The blunderbuss in Spanish was referred to as a trabuco. Okay? So a trabuco is a short range weapon, and it has this flaring muzzle. The flaring muzzle is for three purposes. The first purpose is it looks intimidating. Right? It's a very, very big looking pole. And so if you're going to be arming up on the Spanish frontier and you're going to be worried about being assailed by hostile Indians or attacked by bandits, you want to have this kind of ostentatious large gun. Like, look, we're armed. The other purpose that the muzzle serves is that it's easier to load. So if you're trying to reload on the back of a horse or on top of a jolting wagon or on the rolling and pitching deck of a ship, it's behooves you to have a flared muzzle to load it. The third reason is that this throws the shot in a wider pattern, okay? So you are basically going for extra hit probability. You're losing accuracy, but you're gaining a swath that you can basically hit with pellets that you load out of it. It was once thought that this didn't throw the shot out wider. This has been laid to rest by Mythbusters.
Okay. The Alamo Defenders had muskets and pistols and rifles and, most importantly, artillery. A lot of artillery. I'm going to start things off with the rifle. The rifle, which is what Mrs. Smith is holding over here. It, like the name implies, it is rifle. So inside the barrel, there are a series of cut grooves. Those cut grooves will impart a little spin on the ball, make the ball more accurate. Normally, there's about seven of them. Rifles are very accurate, especially these hunting long rifles that a lot of the Alamo Defenders would have been bringing. Their own personal firearms. So it will take a minute, up to a minute, to reload and fire this hunting rifle. You're going to hit your target, but maybe someone with a musket can fire maybe four times at you before you're able to pop a shot off back. Mrs. Smith is going to fire three shots out of her long rifle. Again, it's going to be very loud, so if you have sensitive hearing, please cover those ears.
So that's it. I'm in the church as part of the Alamo.
Yes. Where's the basement?
Excuse me?
Aren't we going to see the basement?
There's no basement at the Alamo.
Hey, Jimmy, as Pee Wee Herman said, there ain't no basement at the Alamo, right? All right, Texas, it's a hot one. Now it's 95. I'm thirsty. I wonder where I could go. Hey, about Withered Souls. I've had their beer before because Karen brought it for me. Who will be a special guest star? So, let's check it out. Oh, is it hot?
I'm at Withered Souls here in San Antonio. Got myself a flight. Already tried them. The hell is really good. And the stout on the end is what started it. Black is beautiful. So, I've had that one before. Really good beers. Time for lunch.
And the Texan brewery tour continues. Second stop, Flying Saucer. Check it out. Did I tell you it's hot? It's 95 Fahrenheit. It's hot. It's hot.
So, I'm at the Flying Saucer here with special guest star. Special guest star camera person, and I got myself a flight. And this is Kolsch. This is a local amber. This is Independence Stash IPA, very good. And this one is Tufts Evil Dankster, which I'm not sure about. This one's really good, and that one I know from Texas.
Good evening from San Antonio. I am at Hugman's Oasis. Yeah, now it's tiki time. And I think I'm in the right place. Sure, I'm in the right place. Yeah, let's check it out. By the way, it's 100 now. So we hit triple digits. It is hot. I hope it's hot inside. Let's go. Thank you. I'm at Hugman's Oasis, and I got a new tiki mug. This is a painkiller. Delicious. Level 2.